So the, anyway, I call this idea triage because on the battlefield, it's a French word. The docs used to divide the people up into three groups, those who were wounded so badly that he couldn't do anything about it, and they go to one side, and those who are going to get better anyway, whether they treat them or not, and then those who where it pays to treat them because you can make a difference. Well, somebody said I should have called it biage, not triage, but anyway, I use that word. One of the things we found is I looked in the literature, put in the Google is wonderful now. You put in the 30 vitamins and minerals, you need 30 different substances to run your metabolism. They're cofactors for enzymes mostly. And if you don't get any one, you die. But the criteria for calling something a vitamin is that the mice die, or people die, or get scurvy or beriberi or some horrible disease. But when I asked about DNA damage, lots of deficiencies cause that. And I kept on wondering, why is nature doing that? Why is it breaking your chromosomes or damaging your DNA when you don't get enough? And some with the literature, some with studies we did. And one day it hit me and I got, this theory came into my head. It's just what nature wants. Because through all of evolution, animals have been running out of vitamins and minerals. You need 30 different ones. And there are about 15 minerals, and you're getting them from the soil. The plants take them up out of the soil. You need magnesium, you need calcium, you need iron, you need zinc. Anyway, there are all these that are involved in metabolism. Zinc is in 2,000 enzymes that have zinc fingers or other wise need zinc, and magnesium's in 500 enzymes or so. Every DNA repair enzyme has magnesium in it, and calcium is in your, and it's also in the bones, and calcium. So we need these substances. Anyway, what I postulated is since the minerals aren't spread evenly through the world, the red soils with a lot of iron, and then the soils with very little iron. The selenium, too much selenium is a poison, and too little selenium is a poison. Selenium is necessary for 25 enzymes or so as a cofactor. And so, and in Europe, the patches of too much selenium and too little selenium. In China, there's a disease called Keshan syndrome, where people get heart disease and other bad things because they're poisoned by too much selenium, but there are also areas where they don't get enough selenium. So each one of these vitamins has been studied very extensively. And so what I postulated, just as an idea that came to my head, is that when you get a little low on any vitamin or mineral, it's in nature's benefit to ration it. And so the way it rations it, where would you expect, if you don't have enough selenium or vitamin K or magnesium or whatever, what's nature going to do? Well, it's going to put it into those proteins, let's say they're 25 selenium proteins or 16 vitamin K dependent proteins. It's going to put it into those proteins that are essential for survival, because what nature wants you to do is survive and reproduce. That's strong selection. And living to 90, nature really doesn't care about your past your reproductive age anyway. So there's not much selection for that. So the enzymes that are keeping you having a long lifespan, and those are the enzymes like DNA repair enzymes, that DNA damage is insidious, and it accumulates through your lifespan and increases your risk of getting cancer all the time. Or one of the vitamin K enzymes is blood clotting. And if you cut yourself and you didn't have blood clotting, you just bleed to death. And that happens often enough that it's an essential protein, where one of the vitamin K proteins prevents calcification of the arteries. They're all calcium binding proteins, vitamin K proteins. And if you don't have that protein, you slowly accumulate atherosclerotic plaques, calcification of the arteries. And that'll eventually lead to heart disease, but it takes 10 years or so. So basically what nature is doing is trading long-term health for short-term health. So, and it wants short-term survival. And it made perfect sense, and evolutionary biologists discussed that concept in other ways, not in the biochemistry. So anyway, I wrote a theoretical paper saying, hey, this is an interesting theory and has a lot of implication for human nutrition. And then later, Joyce McCann in my lab, came into my office one day and said, I'm a little skeptical of your triage theory. I think there's a better way of tackling it. I said, Joyce, what do you want to do? Go to it. She's a really smart cookie. And she said, well, I'll research a couple of one vitamin and one mineral that have been well studied and see is this triage idea that there's a rationing really built in. I called it triage. And I said, terrific, Joyce, go to it. So she turned out two beautiful reviews, one on vitamin K and one on selenium. And they both have a system for rationing so that, for example, in vitamin K, the clotting proteins get it first. And only after they're satisfied do you do prevent calcification of the arteries or prevent cancer or prevent bone fractures. All these things are proteins that help in these things, but it's all insidious damage that you get that's a long-term consequence. In fact, we call those the disease of aging. Your brain so slowly goes out, or your heart slowly goes out, or your DNA gets damaged and you get cancer. And so she showed it's true for both of these systems, and I think it's going to be true for all the vitamins and minerals.